Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralhack.com. Today we're going to be doing another example of how to find the scalar equations of a line. In this problem we're given two points, P1, which is 0, 0, 0, and P2, which is at negative 6, 3, and 5. So along with this information, we're going to need three formulas to help us find the scalar equations of this particular line. So the first one is x equals x sub 0 plus a times t, y equals y sub 0 plus b times t, and z equals z sub 0 plus c times t. And in order to use these formulas, we need a point and a vector. We need the point to find x sub 0, y sub 0, and z sub 0. We need the vector to find a, b, and c. Unfortunately, in our case, we don't have a vector, we only have two points. So what we need to do is use the information given to us in these two points to calculate the vector. Then we'll use the vector and P1 to find x, y, and z. And the three of those together will constitute our scalar equations, and that'll be our final answer. So in order to find the vector, this is what we do. We're going to find the vector that starts at P sub 1 and goes to P sub 2. And in order to do that, we have to subtract the P sub 1 values from the P sub 2 values, more or less. Remember that vectors involve the variables here I, j, and k. So all we do when we're given two points is use the points here as coefficients on I, j, and k. So remember we said we were subtracting p sub 1 values from p sub 2 values, which means our p sub 2 values here are going to come first. So you can see we took negative 6 and made it the coefficient on I, 3 becomes the coefficient on j, and 5 becomes the coefficient on k. So we end up with negative 6i plus 3j plus 5k. And then from that, we subtract our p1 values, again, making here x, y, and z coefficients on I, j, and k, respectively. So we set this up in this way. This is going to give us the vector v. And now we just subtract. In this case, it's easy because we have 0, 0, and 0 for the three terms here. So we're left with just the first term, negative 6i plus 3j plus 5k, and that's our vector. So given this vector now, we're going to use this and p sub 1 to find our scalar equations and using these formulas here. So remember for x sub 0, y sub 0, and z sub 0, we'll use x, y, and z here in p sub 1. So we'll plug in this 0 here for x sub 0, the second 0 for y sub 0, and the third one for z sub 0. We will pull a, b, and c from the coefficients on I, j, and k, respectively. So a is the coefficient on I, in this case negative 6, b is the coefficient on j, which is 3, and c is the coefficient on k. That's where those values are going to come from. So we'll get these three equations here. X equals 0, that comes from x sub 0, which comes from this 0 here, and then minus 6t, we pull this negative 6 here for a. We'll get y equals 0 plus 3t, and z equals 0 plus 5t. So once you set up those three equations, if they're simplified as much as they can be, then you're done. In this case, obviously, it's redundant to have the three zeros here as terms in these equations. So we'll take those out and we'll get x equals negative 6t, y equals 3t, and z equals 5t. And when we put those three together, we'll get our final answer. These three equations here together constitute our scalar equations of this line. So that's it. That's all we have to do when we're given two points. Remember, find the vector first, then use the vector along with p sub 1 to find your three equations using these formulas here, and you'll be set. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!